Hi, Barrow families. We're so excited to bring you a special edition of Barrow Bedtime Stories tonight. We've missed you guys already. Thank you for spending your evening with us. We know that you're on break. And we really hope you all have a wonderful Thanksgiving tomorrow. So we have a special guest reader reading The Night Before Thanksgiving. We hope you enjoy it.
Good evening, I'm Miss West from Barrow Elementary, the assistant principal, and this evening I'm going to read to you The Night Before Thanksgiving by Natasha Wing, illustrated by Tammy Lyon. 'Twas the night before Thanksgiving, and all through the nation, families got ready for the big celebration. At our house, my mom baked three kinds of pies, pecan and pumpkin and apple surprise. That night, we were nestled all snug in our beds while visions of turkey legs danced in our heads. The very next morning, Thanksgiving, yippee, we got up and watched the parade on TV. Relatives arrived from near and far, by taxi and airplane, by train and by car. My brother came up the basement stairs, lugging the kids' tables and folding chairs. We counted and polished our best silverware, then set the two tables with patience and care. The turkey went in, and as more cousins came in, I laughed and I shouted and I called them by name. Hi, Danny. Hi, Donnie. Hi, Polly and Vicky. Hi, Casey. Hi, Kathy. Hi, Brenda and Ricky. Come in from the porch, step in the hall. Now come and play, come and play, come and play all. So up to my room, my cousins, they flew. We played with my toys and computer games too. We made pilgrim hats and funny shoe buckles, then put on a skit for our aunts and our uncles. All were assembled except Uncle Norm, who called us to say that he was stuck in a storm. Meanwhile, my mother was getting out yams, cranberry jelly, and honey-baked hams. When Mom wasn't looking, we stuck olives on fingers, said that they were puppets and grand opera singers. While dinner was cooking, we played dodgeball outside. Our tummies were growling. Can we eat yet? We cried. The timer then sounded. The turkey was cooked. Mom opened the oven, she sniffed and she looked, when what to our watering mouth should appear but a marvelous bird, which caused us to cheer. Its skin oh so golden, the drumstick so juicy, the stuffing was fluffy, thanks to my Aunt Lucy. Dad slid out the bird, it weighed 30 pounds. He turned, then he tripped over one of our hounds. Up in the air, the turkey did fly over the string beans and straight for a pie. My brother and I made such a clatter as we leaped and we caught the bird on the platter. All right, said Grandpa, get on with the carving. Can't you see that these people are starving? Dad spoke not a word, but he went straight to work. He sliced up the turkey, then he turned with a jerk. In front of our house, we heard beeps of a horn. A trucker delivered, none other than Norm. With a wink in his eye and a twist of his head, the party can start. I made it, Norm said. We all took our places. This food smelt so great. We started to dig in, but Dad said to wait. We're thankful that everyone is together this year, in our home and our hearts, where we hold you so dear. We ate and we ate, yet last but not least, the very next day was a leftovers feast. We hope that you and your family have a great Thanksgiving.
We hope you enjoyed our story. We hope you have a wonderful Thanksgiving, and we will see you guys on Monday for the next Barrow Bedtime Story. Bye.